Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. In this video, I will be doing a review of the brand new Waves OVox plugin. So, a review and a walkthrough of this plugin, and at the end of the video, at this time code, I will be doing a creative playthrough with OVox. Don't forget to like this video and please subscribe to our channel, and let's start. The OVox plugin is basically a vocoder on steroids. To put it simply, a vocoder takes an incoming signal, which is usually a voice, and takes its amplitude and volume to shape another sound, which is usually a synthesizer.
It will sound like this. I am a robot.
An example of the usage of a vocoder is Daft Punk's Harder, Faster, Better and the song Let's Groove by Earth, Wind & Fire. Let's do a walkthrough of the controls of the OVox plugin. First I will play a clean vocal track, which I will use as an example for this OVox review.
Come and let me in, I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now, can't get me out.
That was the clean vocal. Let's now insert OVox. OVox has two views. It has a collapsed view and an expanded view. Let's start off with the collapsed view and play the same vocal track with OVox in its default setting.
Come and let me in, I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now, can't get me out.
Okay, let's go over the controls. There's an OVox 1 and an OVox 2 controller, which are the oscillators of OVox. They have the same controls, so let's focus on the left side. You have an on and off button, a tune, formant, and a gain. On and off turns the oscillator on and off. Tune changes the pitch of the oscillator. It can go up and down by 24/7 tones or 2 full octaves.
Come and let me in, I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
Then we have formant. Formant controls the frequency shift of the formant.
Come get me out, come and let me in.
And then we have gain, which is volume.
In your system now.
Okay, let's go to the top bar. As you can see, there are many controls. And we start off with the first one, which is voice. Voice sets the modulator, which is the input source. It can be what's on the tracks, like this vocal, or whatever you sent as a sidechain. So you have two options, track and sidechain. Then we have gate and gain. The gate gates the input source so you can clean up low noise and stuff like that. It sounds like this.
Come and let me in, I'm not one shy away. I'm in your system now.
It's really an on and off gate, so it has a really steep threshold and a really firm ratio. It would be nice if there was some sort of attack and release control in there, but there isn't. You could of course always insert a gate before this plugin if you want the original audio to be cleaned up. And then we have gain, the volume of the input. And then we have synth. A synth is the carrier signal or what gets modulated by the input. You can choose between the internal synth, which is the OVox synthesizer, the track, so whatever is on the track, but then you have to choose a different input. And you have sidechain, so you can use what's on the audio track to modulate something which you send to the sidechain. I can show you that with a guitar track, which is on over here. So I will set the sidechain. Sidechain input will be guitar, like this, and then it sounds like this.
Come and let me in, I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
Because I chose a guitar, it almost sounds like a talk box now, not a vocoder, but a talk box. That's actually a really good use of this plugin.
Can't get me out.
Okay, let's go back to internal. And then we have drive and gain. These only work on the track signal and the side change signal that's used on track. It adds harmonics and saturates the signal.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away.
So you have that option here. Then we go to note source, which is pretty important because that is what triggers the notes Ovox plays. So you can set it to voice, and then it uses the voice, the modulated track, to determine what notes it needs to play. You can choose MIDI, so you can use a MIDI keyboard or a MIDI track like over here to trigger the notes in Ovox. And you have auto, which is a combination of the input and the MIDI. It first detects what's on the voice track, and if it then notices in the MIDI note or a note by notes map is played, it will switch to that. So it is a combination of both. Minimum note is what is the lowest note Ovox will trigger. So if you have a bit of low end rumble, I would increase it to whatever C1, C2 or something like that. Then you have tolerance, which sets how Ovox reacts on the incoming signal. You can choose sense and time. With sense, you can make sure Ovox won't trigger too early on a little bit of wobbling vocals. You can determine tolerance by 50 cents to up almost 200. So that's a pretty broad range. And you can also set the timing, so it doesn't need to react quickly or pretty slow. You can play with the settings to improve the note detection. Let's do it right now.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
Yeah, that will do. And then there is an arpeggiator, which has a range of 4 octaves. It can go down, up and down, and more settings. You can choose the rate from 4 bars to 1/64th of a note. So that's pretty broad. Let's play a bit. Let's see if it sounds a bit okay with this vocal. 2 octaves and down.
I am in your system now. Can't get me out. Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I'm in your system now.
Not really suited for this vocal, but it works. And then we have note mapper, which is a pretty important part of Ovox because it decides which notes Ovox will play based on which notes are on the input. So let's turn it on. You can set the root note of the track here. Let's leave it on C, and let's leave the preset on major pop. And it sounds like this.
Come and let me in. I'm not one shy away.
Different preset.
I am in your system now. Can't get me out. Come and let me in. I'm not one shy away.
As you can see, there are many, many, many presets for chords, scales, harmonies, etc. And the cool part is you can decide which notes Ovox will play by going into the edit menu. Let's play a bit.
Come and let me in. I'm not one shy away.
So the white notes are the notes which Ovox detects, and the blue one are the ones Ovox will play.
I'm in your system now.
And you can edit those by going into these pink ones, selected notes. For instance, this low C. It will play a C, another C, etc., etc. And you edit them like this. You can click on them, and then they disappear. And you can add them in like this. So when there's a low C, now Ovox will play a C and an E and a G. I have already made a little monotone in C preset just to show you how it sounds. So every note now is set to C. You have to do it for every note. It's not like you change one note and every changes automatically. You have to do it for every triggered note. So within this range. So now all notes will trigger that low C.
Come on, let me in.
that creates that robotic sound. So you can really go in depth and create interesting harmonies based on the notes. Let's continue with the controls. You have spread and vault. If you select spread, the notes played by Ofox will follow which octave the notes are. So if you have a low C, Ofox will play that low C. If you go to C2, Ofox will play C2, etc. With vault, Ofox will only play the notes within this one octave. So it doesn't matter if it's a low C, a C4, C3, it will always play the C1. So which one is useful really depends on the harmonies and arrangements you have chosen for the track. Let's go back to the collapsed view. Now we have these controls, sibilance, which determines how much of the original sibilance, the T's and S's, will be mixed in with the Ofox sound to keep it natural.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
You can even use the button exclusive over here. When there's too much T's and S's, you can use this to bypass Ofox on those T's and S's. It does it automatically to keep it sound pleasant, because if you have a natural T and then boosted T by Ofox, it will get really harsh. Then we have the voice, which will blend in the original incoming signal.
Can't get me out. Come on, let me in.
It's a little bit of tuning. Hard is extreme tuning for vocal effects and notes. Then the incoming vocal will be tuned based on the notes selected in Note Mapper. There's not much to tweak over here except for these presets. For instance, if you have that free plugin Sibilance by Waves, you can tune a lot more. It would be nice if they included that over here, but they didn't. But you can always use a tuning plugin, of course, if you want more tweakability. There's a high pass over here.
I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
And Ofox to get an even more natural result.
Can't get me out.
And then you have synth, which will blend in the oscillates before it's modulated.
Come on, let me shy away.
And then we have Ofox, which will blend in the amount of the processed signal.
I am in your system now.
So you can really create a blend with these three. And then you have tone, which is a tilt shift EQ. So if you lower it, it will increase the low end and reduce the high ends. And if you increase it, it will increase the high ends and lower the low end, like this.
Can't get me out. Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away.
So really it's a tilt shift, like this. The output button is the output volume of the entire plugin, and the limiter will limit the plugin to 0 dB, so you won't get clips and peaks. Before I forget, we have done this entire review with one oscillator, and you have the second oscillator, which can be turned on and has the same settings as the first oscillator. And you can use that one to blend in a second tone.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
So you can make it a bit fatter, a bit fuller and stuff like that with the second one. Let's turn it off again. And let's go to mods and effects. But for that I need to change the preset, because this default setting does not use any mods or effects. Let's go to dreaming. It sounds like this. Now the exciting part. Mods will determine how much modulation there was in the track. So let's turn it off. And effects will determine how much of the effects are on Ofox. Etc. But how do I tweak those mods and effects? Well, for that you have to go into the expanded view. Here is the expanded view. Let's first go back to the full reset. So this is the expanded view. It looks a lot like the collapsed view, but every parameter has more possibilities to tune and fine tune, etc., etc. Let's start over with OVox 1. As you can see, there's now a square over here, which allows you to have more variations in the waveform used. It sounds like this.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
So it has a frequency swap, and it also has harmonics added or removed. With this harmonics, but you could even add more harmonics.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away.
So you can tweak even more, and you can choose more versions like this. Churchill, call me whatever.
I'm in your system.
Which all has their own frequency shift to it. You have a noise button over here, so that one adds noise.
Let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
And you can fine-tune that noise with a low and high pass.
Don't let me out. Come on, let me in.
The tune button is the same as in the collapse view, only now you have a fine tune button next to it.
I'm not one shy away.
Which does 100 cents up and down. The formant filter. This is really important for OVox because this is what decides how it mimics the human voice. If you go to focus, it will set the frequency range OVox will focus on to determine its sound, and the Q will set the range, how broad or how small that focus point is. And the speed button will determine how quickly OVox switches between one state or the other state to make it sound natural. If you keep it really short, it will be very accurate, and if you keep it very slow, it almost sounds like humming. So let's play around with that one.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away.
Let's go to voice dynamics. Voice dynamics is how much of the original amplitude is transposed to the carrier.
One shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
Panning is what it says, left or right.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away.
And gain is the output volume. You can make OVox sounds bigger and thicker and fatter by changing the number of voices. It usually has one voice.
Come on, let me in.
And if you increase that, it will add more voices. And with detune, you can tune how much each voice is detuned and compared to the other.
I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
So they can change to sound a bit fatter or really chorusy. Spread determines how much the individual voices will be spread across the spectrum. 90 is full stereo and 0 is mono. And if you add in the second oscillator, which does exactly the same, you can even get more fat and stuff like that.
Your system now can get me out. Come and let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
It's quite a difference.
Can't get me out.
So you can also play around with that one. Okay, let's go to the bottom section. Let's start out with EQ, which is an EQ.
Come and let me in. I'm not one shy away.
You have four bands, you can drag them, and you can change the shape to like shelf, high pass, low pass, bell, low shelf. These four bands all are completely tweakable over the entire frequency spectrum, so that is nice.
I'm in your system now.
You have gain, frequency, and the Q.
Can't get me out.
So that will help you out tweak your sound even more. Effects. Press plus. You have a plugin list. Then you have a number of plugins. So chorus, compressor, delay, distortion, limiter, reverb. Let's start with compressor. It's a basic compressor. A few settings. You can blend in how much it is, how much it compresses. You can tweak the attack and you can tweak the mix, and that's it. And you have to choose with these presets if you want to have a soft compression, normal compression, or hard compression. So the ratio settings. And let's add a delay or something. Then you have some presets too.
I'm not one shy away. I am in your system. Can't get me out.
So also basic settings. If you want more tweakability, you will have to use an extra plugin. But this will do for the most part. Nice is that you can switch the effects around, so they're not fixed to one position. So you can tweak that even more. And then we go to these mysterious numbers. M1, M2, M3, M4, A1, A2, AM, PT, and FR. The first one, mod 1, is an LFO and a sequencer. And it goes for the other three as well. You can switch between an LFO and a sequencer. And you can draw in whichever form you want. And you have a preset over here. You can choose between many, many types of LFO forms and shapes. With this one, the rate, you will determine how quickly the LFO is working on the sequencer. The phase, you can shift the form around a bit. The smoothness will determine how smooth it will follow the original LFO. So if you have a shape like this, it will smoothen out this extreme graph. And warp, you can adjust the timing, which is fun. See, now it starts slowly, ends quickly, or the other way around. So a lot of tweakability like that. But how do you use something like this in a track? Well, here's the fun part with the tweakability of OVox. If you go around with your cursor, you will see all these gray squares light up. These are all slots where you can insert modulation. So you grab M1 and let's go to tune. Let's find the first slot. As you can see over here, all these gray areas are now highlighted. So now I've added modulation 1 to the first slot of tune. Like this, it won't do anything yet.
Let me in. I'm not one shy away.
And for that, you have to click the M1 and then drag your mouse up or down. And as you can see, it will create these lines in this button, which say how much it will be modulated. And it will sound like this.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
And you can use this modulation also on EQ, which is kind of nice. Let's do it with frequency. And then we do the same thing.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
Etc. etc. You can really tweak and create unique sounds with this setting. The way it does it reminds me a lot of Native Instruments Massive, which has a similar system. You drag a modulation source onto a oscillator or whatever knob and you tweak it. So M1, M2, M3, M4 are all the same. So you have more sources of modulation. Let's go to A1, which is an ADSR filter. So you can set the attack, decay, sustain, and release with either dragging or using these knobs. And you can change the curve over here, but it also does it like that. So you drag them or you draw them, or you use these knobs to shape your ADSR. You can use that on everything again. So if you want to reduce some attacks, you can use this one pretty nicely. The AM or amplitude module lets you use the amplitude envelope of the voice signal to manipulate other controls of the plugins. Works a bit like an envelope filter. So first I need to boost the input gain. Okay, let's try it.
I'm not I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
Okay, let's use it on, let's see, gain.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out. Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
It allows for even more tweakability. PT is pitch. With this you can use the pitch information to modulate sources within OVOX. Let's move this one. So, for instance,
can't get me out.
Let's use this one on an EQ. EQ. And let's go to this one, for instance. Let's go to frequency and tweak around like this. Let's see what happens.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out. Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away.
You can use this one to fine-tune EQ, actually, or something like a server EQ where the frequency follows the pitch of the voice. It's really nice. Then we have formant, which does something similar as pitch, only uses the pitch of the formant to modulate different sources.
I am in your system now. Can't get me out. Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
You really can see it working over here.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now. Can't get me out.
So let's use the tune just for the sake of using it.
Come on, let me in. I'm not one shy away. I am in your system now.
So you can really tweak with these. So as you notice, it's really versatile. You can really go in depth with all these modulation, amplitude and pitch sources to modulate different types and places and oscillators in this plugin. The only limitation is your creativity. I didn't show you yet, but you can use these modulation also to modulate the effects. Which parts you can modulate, you can see it with these gray squares. So really, the sky is the limit with this plugin. Let's play around now with these audio tracks I have loaded in on this project. So there's a kick, a snare, an overhead. The snare actually already has OVOX on it. I tweaked around with it a little bit before. It has the preset sub octave because I like that one. It has distortion stuff like that, but listen to it. Almost adds a bit of a 808 type of snare sound to it. Bass drum. Has no OVOX on it. Let's try to create a bit of sub bass. Where is my OVOX? It's over here. Okay. Okay, let's duplicate the track and bring back the original kick. Like that, no effect. Let's add a high pass because I added low end, like this. That's nice. Let's see how it sounds together. So I just tweaked around a little bit, and you can see what you can achieve with this limited amount of time. So it really allows you to go really in depth, and it's not limited to voice alone, but you can use it on like drums, like guitars, vocals, snare was really useful in this one. So I see it's used as a creative tool. You can get new ideas from it by just tweaking the parameters and stuff like that. But also as an addition in the mix, because I easily created a sub bass with this one. And again, with the snare drum, I replaced it from an acoustic snare to an electronic sounding snare. It has a little bit of that building block feel the latest Wave plugins have, I must say. So you take a bit of the plugin Sibilance and a bit of Mofoda, and you add them together, they're like this, and you have a new plugin. But they wrap it in a package, which makes it really easy to use. You can really just use the standard settings and get good results and really go in depth and go crazy. So, yeah. I understand the hype they are creating with this plugin, because it really is a useful and actually creative and good plugin. That's it for this review and walkthrough of the Waves OVOX plugin. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below and I'll answer them as quickly as possible. Please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye!